Hello YouTube, it is Chris here, and in today's episode we're going to be talking about concealing your EDC and survival gear. Stick with me. Welcome back, everybody, and thank you for sticking with me. Like I said, today we're going to be discussing concealing your everyday carry and survival gear.
For those of you fans of the outdoors, we just dropped our Get Outside shirt, which is our limited edition Drop 4 Survival merch for 2018. If you want it, the sale lasts for about 9 boring days. Link in the video description. Once they're gone, they're gone.
For those of you who follow my channel regularly, you know we love covering the topic of everyday carry because, in my personal opinion, your EDC gear is the gear that you're going to have on you 95% of the time when you are away from your home, your fortress, your castle. Those backup tools are going to be the things that can assist you or save your butt if you run into an emergency.
So the first few items we're going to be discussing are basically accessories and add-ons. So the first off is this koozie. Now, that seems silly, but this is more recreational, but it's still viable. It gives you an ability to have bottles of water, drinks, beverages, beer, anything you want in here, but you still have your koozie, but it still gives you 95 feet of paracord, and the drawstring right here is fire cord. Then you have a ferro rod right here. You have the emergency whistle, a ceramic scraper. This is actually made by Wazoo Survival Gear. Now, you've seen the bigger versions of those that actually hold 40-ounce Nalgene bottles and clean canteens. They can hold the big stuff. They can also double in an emergency as a foraging pouch. If cordage isn't really a big issue for you, you can do that. And without actually destroying your system, you can actually pull in the drawstring just a little bit with the scraper and the ferro rod and use that to actually start igniting and scraping sparks to start a fire. Then as we move on, there's varying degrees of how rigged out you really want to be. But let's say you just want to keep it simple. You're not really feeling the whole tactical vibe today. So Wazoo Survival Gear actually made two separate, the Bushcraft necklace and the Bushcraft bracelet. And they're basically, it's a ferro rod on a leather band. It's really, really nice, fashionable, looks good. But no one really suspects these of being anything. It takes a really discerned eye to really know what these are. We covered this more in depth in my everyday carry video, but I'll still overlay the footage where my son actually had to start a fire with this. Every single member of my family has one of these. Then on my watch, this is my normal Casio G-Shock. You guys saw this in the EDC video. This is in every single EDC video. This is the compass by Wazoo Survival Gear. Gotta buy this separate, guys. I know a lot of people asked in the comments, what didn't come with it? You gotta buy it. It's like 15, 20 bucks. Just pick it all up. It's awesome because this is a Japanese compass, so it's kerosene filled. So it's gonna actually work in more environments and more altitudes than any other liquid filled compass on the market, especially button compasses. This is probably the highest grade button compass out there. And then I have a covert polymer handcuff key right here for unlawful detainment. Now, these are some several bracelets. One is from Super SC Straps. This is pretty much the number one guy on social media for bracelets. He does a lot of cool stuff. This is called the EDC Prepper bracelet. I do wear this one from time to time. Now, my daily driver, what I wear the most often, is the Zombie bracelet from Wazoo Survival Gear. It's got, I think, 12 or 14 different tools on it, from a wire saw built inside to the reflective mirror on the inside, the whistle, the ferro rod, the scraper, the ranger bands, the fishing kit inside, and also the fat packs for fire starting and first aid. For those who want to be ultra minimalist, this is just the minimalist bracelet, obviously by Wazoo Survival Gear. It's just got a fishing kit inside and it has the Firestorm buckle. So we have all the goodies built inside, but without the bulkiness and the weight. So if you want to be more minimalist and more discreet and relaxed and chill, this is a really cool option. And then I got my wallet. This is a no-brainer for concealing some survival tools and items. Like I said, you guys saw this in my EDC that was just a few days ago. When you pull everything out, this is actually what's inside. So I've covered this, like I said, this is the Lever Tool Card Pro. It's an urban survival item. Then I have a glow mat right here. We'll overlay the footage where I glowed on that. I've got three sear strips. The reason I have exactly three is they fold down really, really flat. But the reason why these are my wallet under any other fire tender is not because they're the world's best fire starter. They're actually not the world's best fire starter. There are plenty of them out there that are amazing. However, what gives this the bacon? It's waterproof. It will start with any three methods that you choose to use, whether it's a spark wheel, a lighter, or a ferro rod. They will light and it will work even if submersed prolonged underwater. It will actually help you clean firearm parts in the field. And it can also help you with, because of the wax properties in this thing, will help you lubricate zippers. So it's waterproof, packability, reliability in the field, and the ability that three of these rolled up can actually help you boil water in an emergency. This is just for me as an emergency fire starter for a multitude of options, varieties, and uses. It's just a stupid no-brainer. Then we have a tool card from Grim Workshop. Then we've got the sharpening plate right here from Wazoo Survival Gear. And then I've got a signal mirror and a Fresno lens that is actually the same one that's in my DFS Micro Survival Kit. Whoopsh. Shameless plug right there. It has my signal mirror and a Fresno lens, like I said. So I have quite a few options that stay just in my wallet. Next, we're gonna be covering morale patches and hats. Now, a normal hat can't conceal a small amount of gear, but this particular hat is special. This is the Cash Cap, like 2.0 from Wazoo Survival Gear. Now, you'll notice Wazoo Survival Gear is getting the treatment pretty heavily in this video, but they're kind of the masters and the mad scientists around the wearable concealment. Now, there are a lot of companies gonna be shown. You're gonna see a lot more of them later on. But these morale patches actually come from a good buddy, Wes over at Super Essie Straps. These things are awesome. These are concealment patches that are freaking terrific. Now, this one has a fire starting kit inside here, and it's got a ferro rod, H2O, has foil tablets. We have a ferro rod built inside here. But the reason I put this particular one in my kit is because it's got tap code and Morse code. I don't have that stuff memorized. I did when I was a kid, when I was in the Boy Scouts, but I don't have it memorized anymore. So it's a cool reference in an emergency. Now, while we were out and about, we actually wanted to take this out around town from various places. We had some errands to run for my day job. For you guys who don't know, I'm a commissioned painter. I paint miniatures for clients. My wife does that too, part-time after her daytime job. So we just wore this around town. We went around different shopping complexes and plazas and just all over the place, and just wanted to see if people were paying attention and noticing and took notice of anything that how my wife and I were dressed, and no one better than I. Now, that may be because in the city of San Antonio, it's a funky town because of the fact that we are considered a military city, USA. We have 5 military bases. So people that are dressed in military garb, that are in tactical clothing, that are in more of a law enforcement standpoint, that we're so used to seeing it constantly with hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of thousands of service members, men and women that are in our city. You just don't even, it doesn't even register anymore. It's not cool, crazy, special, or eye-opening at this point. You do notice them, but it's just another person in the crowd. However, there's a lot of people out there that wear skinny jeans, unicorn backpacks, they have purchased satchels, fanny packs, backpacks, and carrying something like this, if you really wanted to go hardcore, wouldn't be weird in my city. So you're definitely gonna be demographic specific, because if you live in a town where that would be considered weird, then you wanna be more low key, which is why these kind of undercover options make a little more sense. And what I'll do is I'll go ahead and take everything out of the hat so you can kind of see what we got going on right here. So I've got the ferro rod, got the ceramic knife. In the brim of this cap, there's another fold. I've got the aluminum foil built inside. And then we have some useful goodies in here. I've got some duct tape, have some brass snare wire and some fishing line. And I think that's it for that spot. Then right here, we've got an emergency signal mirror from Seoul. Then I've got the hooks, weights, and a needle for the fishing kit right in here. And then on the other side, we've got a nice little goodie. We have the DermaSafe knife that is actually in my DFS Micro Survival Kit. So this just gives you an example. You can stick IDs, money, you can just use this as a travel wallet to hide some stuff. So if people try to pickpocket and steal your wallet, they necessarily won't take your hat and steal all your goodies and belongings. Next are my belts. They range in price, size, usefulness, the whole nine. This is a paracord belt by my buddy Preppenstein. This was actually used to be sold by Wazoo Survival Gear. But the goodies and the awesomeness about this is it's a really comfortable belt. You get between 100 and 125 feet of paracord, depending on how you want to use it. And it's a normal paracord belt, but there is a nice little fire steel scraper right in here where the belt loop is. But it here, you can actually grab and take all the survival kit items right in here without actually destroying your belt. So you can actually just undo this system, pull that stuff out and reattach it. And if you want to save the cordage and your belt usage for later, you can. It's ready to go when you need it. Now, there are two other options for people who where cordage is not a concern. These are made from slide belts. These are the survival belts. You've seen this on my channel before, and you've seen it on other channels. This is the black one. I don't wear this one very often, but I wanted to kind of show you the buckle and break it down. I typically wear the OD green one. As you can see, I have tan, OD green, and black. These are my kind of daily drivers that I wear most often. But it is a ratcheting slide belt that has a 2,000 pound capacity, and you can incrementally increase the tension or loosen up. So as you gain and lose weight, you become less in shape or more in shape. You can change this belt option. And once you buy the belt, you don't have to buy a new one, which is freaking fantastic. But right in here, they have a liner lock folding knife built inside this bad boy, which is freaking sweet. And then they have another goodie built inside. They also have a bottle opener. And then right here, we have a ferro rod that does work really, really well. And then we've got a flashlight. So it gives you some cool survival tools that are concealed in your belt. It's just another option. And this particular belt is super, super, super tough and super, super, super strong. And the other thing that makes this belt really nice is because of the polypropylene core in the center, it can be also used as a gun belt. Then last but not least is my cash belt from Wazoo Survival Gear. This is the Riggers version. They do have an EDC version that they are finishing up the buckles on right now. I love this freaking belt. I wear this belt most often because it gives me a 27 inch cache, just like the cache had, to store a bunch of freaking stuff. And I'm not gonna rip everything open, but I have a ferro rod and a scraper built inside. On the other side of this bad boy, we've got, this thing's completely rigged out. And then we've got a compass, we have zip ties, we have a whistle, got a little bit of everything. I don't wanna take all this stuff out, but I've got a wire saw built inside right here. But this belt is completely rigged out with anything and everything you would want. Now let's say some of the items that you may wanna put in there are illegal in certain countries. You can still put your vital documents, spare cash, ID cards, little micro flash drives with vital documents if you have to go to like a US embassy or a consulate to verify who you are because people stole your stuff. You have a way to hold your stuff securely while you're traveling. This belt is super functional and it's designed to give you a wide plethora. So if you combine like this with the cash hat, holy freaking crap, without even putting anything in your pocket, you've given yourself a boatload of backup tools and you don't look weird. And that's what I'm trying to say is while we're overlaying some of this footage of us kind of out and about around town, no one batted an eyelash. We just look like normal people because we are, but we don't want people to know that we've got all these survival kit items because that would make us a target if we ran into an emergency. So having the stuff on us yet concealed is of vital importance in my opinion. So in conclusion, I hope this discussion point and topic gave you some ideas of some commercially available things that you can pick up and look into for creating concealable wearable options for your everyday carry and backup survival tools. Now, these aren't designed to replace any of the components you would put in a full-on survival kit, a get-home bag, or a bug-out bag, but they give you some vital tools and space and storage to put it on instead of just jamming into your pockets and looking like some crazy doofus out of a McDonald's commercial. The winner of yesterday's Amazon gift card giveaway is Carla Parker. Congratulations, Carla Parker. You're the winner, so definitely go to the back of your channel so we can get your contact details. But that is the buzzer for now. If you enjoyed this discussion point of concealing your EDC and survival gear items, definitely give this video a big thumbs up and share this out with your friends and family in your social media networks so we can keep growing, thriving, and making awesome videos for you guys. But that is the buzzer for now. Hope you guys have an absolute wonderful day. I'm out.